Ah, now I welcome you back. Welcome back. Welcome. Now, thank you for joining me. We learned in part one so far that my rotations around the map aren't perfect. At the early game, they were doing all right. We were doing okay. We were having some good rotations. We were actually transitioning our lead that we had built up bottling with some flashy plays. We did have some flashy plays there. We were transitioning that to the rest of the team. We were getting the right objectives. That's why you can see we already have some turrets down significantly. Both the outer and inner mid turrets are down. That's good. But then we started to rotate poorly, and that's when we started to lose control around here. We lost a Baron. We lost a big series of kills top. We lost a top outer, and now we're about to lose a top inner. Right? And now we're in the flame question marks being, well, Lucian more than me, but nonetheless, we're involved in that, right? So let's see how the latter half of the game goes. So at this point, I hesitate a little bit, thinking, okay, are they going to keep pushing? If so, I need to rotate here and try and enable a flank, because Orianna's going to be coming up, Lucian's going to be coming across. That's roughly matching with my involvement. If I can come in on a flank and get a good initiation from a hook, if I can get a good box down that hits a lot of them with multiple walls, ideally, that's good. So I'm looking for the flank. Lucian hasn't come straight over yet, so I don't want to dive right in. So I keep backing off, but I want to come in, you know? I know Jan is there placing those. Now that they commit a little bit more forward, even though Jan is here supposedly controlling the zone, I can start to invade it, cut it off, force the confrontation here. Because right now, they're just getting free damage onto this turret. Something's got to change, right? So they decide, okay, let's turn and focus on Orianna right as I'm coming in for the fight. This is actually pretty good timing. It's unfortunate that they're probably going to be able to kill Orianna, but it's good timing that I'm coming here because it breaks up their team. Oops, not that. Let's go to... There we go. There's our drawing tool. So it breaks up their team by me coming in here. I actually should be coming in a little bit closer to the minions rather than skirting this wall, trying to maintain a shot on Janna. Because doing this does that too, but it establishes a break a lot more than coming in like this does, because this establishes a break like this, which is what allows Janna to retreat like this and maintain that certain level of connection to her team and create a zone. If I was pincering a little bit more close to the minion line, it might actually force Janna far enough up to where it breaks this, and then this could be a 2v3. Right? So that's what we want out of this. Want to make sure that this is... Oops. Yeah, we're good. Sorry, just technical difficulty there. So they go in, they are taking turret aggro, and now that I'm here, it's like, whoa, yeah, like this is... I realize now that angle is not as good, so I need to be coming in. Lucian's doing the piercing light just to start his passive, I think, and to clear out some of these minions, because if they're not there to tank or support with a call of help, call for help when we start attacking them. That's going to make this a lot easier. And they are baroned up. That is significant. So I'm running here. I finally get that break in. Right? So now these two are cut off from Janna. So this is now effectively a 2v2. And we've got Lee Sin on the way. He's coming. He's going to be coming and helping us. So if we can keep them here, which is turret... kind of creates the difference there. It's a bit of a 2.5 to 2 by having the turret there. But with the baroned up minions and Janna, it's 2.5 to 2.5. All right, let's keep it real. So we really need Lee Sin to make the difference. Unfortunately, Rammus is the one that presents himself as a target to Lucian. Rammus is definitely not the one you want to go to. He does have Thornmail built too, so that's also getting Lucian prepped for a lot of damage from Callista, who... has a Janna shield on her, I think that's from. I'm not sure exactly how she was able to get it at that distance. Maybe it just hasn't worn off yet, but nonetheless, I'm coming in here again to try and, like, break them apart. And seeing this, it's my job to further break them away from Callista. So I just keep walking, right? I'm not even throwing out abilities yet. I'm just trying to position myself to break this team apart. And now Lee Sin's almost here. We're almost ready to go. And all the meanwhile, this turret is putting in work, right? Even if it's not necessarily hitting somebody who's aggroed it the whole time, it's helping clear out these minions bit by bit. So now I'm establishing a break like this, which makes her isolated. In a 1v2 and a half, or three and a half, would be great. And these guys then all of a sudden, the Rammus and the Janna, have to now break through a line to get to Callista to regroup. And it's kind of becomes like a dive for them that they have to do to save Callista. So, again, I flay, trying to hit both of them, but also trying to, again, emphasize this break, because I'm here. So trying to break them further apart, right? It would put Rammus here and put her there. I want to move her as far this way as possible. Unfortunately, it looks like she does jump out of the way. But I want to have an angle that hits Rammus and her ideally, but pushes her as much downward as possible towards Lee Sin. Fortunately, it looks like I missed both of them. Rammus is tanking this up, but Lucian's got the Choline running, right? So between tanking that up and tanking the Choline, Rammus isn't that tanky. He's going to take some damage. Lee Sin finally regroups, is able to come here, and now the situation of the like team fight orientation really reveals itself. Janna is where they should be, and this is where the critical players are right now. Lee Sin gets a beautiful ultimate. She is toast. I don't even need to land that hook. Would be nice if I did, though. Rammus being troll finally gets finished off by Shen. Lee Sin gonna protect that turret, and I start rotating. Why? Start rotating to try and do my damnedest to protect that mid turret from this guy. Now, I'm just Thresh, but I gotta get there. And if I get there, I can lantern somebody in, right? So I'm zoning him out. He respects it. Jan is there. So we don't even need to really lantern somebody in at this point. Would have been nice to lantern in so he could get the last hits. Minor detail. Not as big a deal. Throw the lantern out to there. Because again, the dragon is up. It is just an air dragon. The dragons haven't been like the most critical dragons. Mountain Drake matters. But since we're not double dipping on any of the elements, they're not as providing as much of an oomph. But they are providing something, so it's always good to clean them up if we can get them. So I'm pulling Lee Sin in here to start establishing a zone of control around Dragon. He just starts it. I throw a pink ward on to make sure there's no wards here in the back that my sweeper lens wasn't getting. Pop this off, both to make sure that they don't get to use it to see us on it and get a quick glimpse at what we're at, but also to see if there's anybody in this part of the jungle. There's not. I throw a ward there in case if somebody like was coming around, we could see that. Great. Canarina revealed herself, pointing out the pink or rotating. However, we knew she was there, so I stay on this side, just waiting for her. Make sure she can't do anything. Fine. Assume she's backed off. So where is the next rotation? Who's next? Next rotation's mid. This is where the conflict is happening, the action's at. Try and find myself a hook. Can't quite get it. He would have been walled it anyway. Fine. Good for Yasuo. Fight. Starting to break out because Rammus wants it to. Rammus is really good at enforcing that kind of rule on people. Yasuo decides not to take the ultimate on me this time, in part because it's a 4v3 right there. So, we do have Callista coming in, but she's not here yet. Shen isn't here, but he does have Stan United, I'm pretty sure. I don't think that's a glitch. So, I do see Callista. We see Callista coming because she's coming through that ward I had placed. So, we start rotating over here to try and get her. Again, that's where the action's happening. This is a really good rotation. This is what I'm talking about. I could be here dinking around, looking for picks and stuff to start a fight that we're not all at. Or I could be right the fuck here, making shit like this possible. So Lee Sin can come in and in-suck a bitch. And now, look at that. She's toast. She's toast. I don't even have to do anything. I could lantern Oriana in and then just spam laugh. And she's toast. Giving him the support to do that. This is on Lee Sin's mechanical ability. Kudos to him. But I have to be here to enable him to know that he can do that. Because even if I super whiff every skill shot I have and don't do anything but spam laugh, I provide a lot of HP in the vicinity. And I have a threat of supposedly not missing all my skill shots. That's enough to give him the confidence to make a play like this. Unfortunately, misses the sonic wave. Lots of damage coming in. This is the most unfortunate thing I've seen in a long time. That's a really good play by Janna. It was a flash ult to save her. And it totally does. And she's a Kalista that has Bork with Hurricane, right? She's got some Maw to give herself an extra bit of magic resistance. But like, the lifesteal that's coming out on multiple targets simultaneously. And it's coming out fast because she's got a lot of attack speed. So it's all stacking multiplicatively. That's crazy. That's crazy. She throws down heal on top of it. And between all that and the Janna shield, she survives this whole thing. So where's the action happening? Now it's happening on me. Well, shit. I'm definitely at the point of action if the point of action is me. I was trying to give a little bit of space to draw them towards me so Lucian can retreat, which he has successfully. Now we're seeing Katarina's flashing to make that not so sure anymore. But also to create space so they can have time 2v1-ing this. Unfortunately, Rammus kind of controls that dynamic, so he's going to wind up winning that fight on his own. Shen finally does use the Stand United. He was a little bit slow, but I know how that happens when you split push. Sometimes you just want to like push that out just a little bit more to secure the wave going in the proper direction. Finally, the Stand United does come out, but now I've become a piece of toast! And I'm about to just get annihilated here. Katarina, again, she wasn't the biggest threat all game, but she has gotten herself some key items. And she's going to be able to beat down the solution. I'm completely, having done zone myself, so Lee Sin has no good place to come in and change this. This doesn't look like much is going to happen. With Shen coming in, this has become a Stand United that we need to retreat with, right? So Lee Sin doesn't have any good where to go. He tries to make a play to come in on Kalista, but Kalista's just going to lifesteal right through him. Between that and the Janna sustain, nothing to be done. Ori comes in, finds a nice shutdown. That's really good to pick up on the backside, right? That gives us a lot more control over the map, too, because they don't have one of their key auto attackers to take turrets with. That's really good. So not as bad as it could have been, but certainly not good. And there wasn't as much of rotations in there that I could have done better, I think. I think that was just a bad fight. We just didn't get a good fight. We weren't properly positioned. So maybe I was a little bit too hasty in picking that fight. You know, I don't know. It happens. Not my best moment, but I'm not going to dwell on it too long. Yeah, believe me, there are more things we need to focus on. So, again, what needs to be focused on? Well, Baron's about to come up, you know, as you can see right here. You can see on the minimap we've got the gray timer. And we had recently taken Dragon. So even though all our vision is positioned aggressively around the Dragon Pit, it's because there was an objective there. We need to transition this vision up here to the Baron area, right? It always hurts to place a pink ward when you've got a pink ward already out, but we need to do that. We need to get some static wards here. Here, let me just do it on the mini map. Here, here, here even would be ideal. Get a pink ward here. This pink ward covers enough of us so we don't necessarily need one in Pixel Brush. Would be also nice to have a pink ward there. But that's a lot of ward movements, right? Not even all that I can do on my own, but I need to start doing my due diligence bringing that. I do have a full sight stone right now, so I can bring that. So I start placing, right? Lee Sin's looking for a kill on Doramus. If we can get this kill on Doramus right before Baron spawns, fabulous! We are going to be up a smite. We're not only going to be in a 4v5, but we're going to be up a smite. So that's a free Baron for us. Callista's not going to be able to start it and already have her Ren stacks in there to secure it beyond either smite. We're going to have priority because it's a 4v5. So she's not going to be able to prep. She can't contest. We have a smite. They don't. Beautiful. So I throw down this ward. Throw down a ward here. Keeping myself out of vision as long as I can. Waiting for Lee Sin to break the vision. So he, again, fed Lee Sin, can make this play happen. Right? Once he does and goes in. Surprise! Here's Thresh. Keep him in there. Pop the coin so we can follow up. Lee Sin decides to secure the red buff. Fine, that's good. If I can land this hook, then we can turn back on him. If not, then we don't have to. I land the hook. Callista is here. She's focused on the top lane. We don't know where they are, right? We don't have vision of them. So it is a little risky. But there was just a fight. They were on the other side of the map around here. So it's not likely they're all here. Once we see Callista, though, that does kind of give the illusion that they all could be anywhere within this vicinity of the map, right? So playing cautiously, and again, since Baron's about to come up and this is going to be a critical Baron that could even decide the game, we don't want to throw right now by me and Lee Sin trying to go ham to secure it just by killing Rammus, who is very tanky at this point in the game, by accidentally getting bushwhacked by like two or three people in that bush, So, discretion being the better part of valor here, Lee Sin's making the right call, I make a different call. You know, because we split our call, then we get in trouble, right? I have to burn flash to get out of there, I've burned my cooldowns. I do take out the blast cone on the way, throw down some vision, whatever. Trying to make the best out of that bad situation. And that really does exemplify the thing that people will tell you of, like, it doesn't matter if you think it's the right call, just make the call, you know? Having five people do the wrong call will get you higher rates of success than one person doing the right call, breaking off from the other four. You know, that fails far more frequently than if you all commit to the right thing. So, Lee Sin and I should have been on the same page there. That's obviously on me. Lee Sin and I, that's half on me. You know? So, having that box up for the next team fight, having my flash up for the next team fight, having been able to get a more favorable retreat here so I could have left a stronger trail of vision through this part of the jungle would have been nice. Luckily, we do find Katarina. We do find Katarina. So that's good. All of a sudden, 4v5. Shen, not sure if his Stan United is actually back up yet, but his TP, I'm almost certain, is back up at this point. So hey, this is a 4v5. We do have some initiative. I start my sweep to make sure it gets this bush so Lee Sin can continue to wait to bushwhack somebody. He can always Sonic Wave over the wall to start with us if he wants to. But now he knows that's clear. These brushes are clear. I dip in Baron. I had seen a ward here, or I had actually attacked it because I placed it as I was retreating over the blast cone. So I clear that one out. I don't have any more Sightstone charges, so I can't create more vision, but it is swept. So as they're recalling, I'm telling them, hey, I just swept it out, Baron's clear, we should set up around Baron. Solution in. Started immediately. Alright, now that's a bit aggressive. We do have a ward here though, so we can possibly make this happen. Shen comes in on the Stan United immediately, just to make sure we get better control. Now, Rammus is back up, and he's here. So Orianna's on the side trying to create pressure. I can't actually see where her ball's at right now. Oh, it's on her because she used Command Shield. I don't see the visual mark for it, though, but regardless, just by her being here, that creates a zone around her if I could do a better arc there. A zone around her where her ball could be. And each point along the zone has a big zone for the shockwave, right? So by doing this, she's creating a lot of pressure to force these guys off of the back side of Baron. And as Rammus is coming in, she's, by doing that, necessitating that he pull his focus onto her, which prevents him from just going straight in, flashing the wall, and trying to make a flashy Baron play. So this is really good zoning out of Orianna, and she's not going to be putting tons of damage. Like, she's going to, what, command move, dissonance, command move. Like, it's much better to have her zoning, and particularly zoning two squishies from their bot lane, than to have her trying to hang out with us. So this is really good play by Orianna. There, we now see the ball. She pops the Banshee's Veil, which makes flashing in even more risky because Shen can taunt him, I can hook him to suppress him, and you know, hopefully throughout all that, it stops him being able to get off his smite properly. He can't use any abilities on it to chunk it out. Now, he's not an Elise. He wasn't going to, like, or Nunu. He wasn't going to, like, consume smite it or Cho'Gath smite ult it. But nonetheless, every bit of advantage helps. So that's good. Calista trying to knock out the pink ward over the wall so they can re-enable their vision. Right now, they know we're on it, but because this red ward, I should say, is canceling their ward's effectiveness, it actually denies them vision, even though they know we're here. So we're still trying to burst this down. Now, this is questionable whether or not we should be peeling at this point, but Orianna's retreating here, and it's clear that Rammus is going to take the long way around. It's at least until here where he could flash, right? Maybe, like, there. You guys can give him the practice tool and practice your flashes, but I think it's, like, right about here where you can flash over the wall. So that buys us some time. So it is possible we could burst it. Now we do start seeing this teleport coming in from Katarina. So this is now a full team fight. Throw down the coin. It actually already, the cooldown's bugged. But I think you saw the coin go out to everybody, so we can reposition. If we need to peel away, even if we don't, even if we secure this, we then need to peel away and reposition properly. So getting that coin out right now is a really good call. Lee Sin secures it because he's a boss. And now, with the Baron secured, hey, he's way out of position. Hey, Katarina is trying to flank, but there's no top to support her because she is the top, right? So if she flanks to try and save him, well, there's no objectives to take on the map. So why are you saving your jungler at this point? Who's a tank too, so maybe he can make it out on his own if he's lucky, you know, or if he decides to go this way and flash the wall, right? But if you come in for a flank like that and you're not tanky, we should just all immediately change focus to her and just burst her out. And then, hey, you know, whatever, they have a jungler up, but we've already got this huge wave pressuring top because Shen prepped the wave properly and stand united. So while we were doing this Baron dance, this huge wave was happening, building up to create pressure on the opposite side of the map. And if we kill somebody on the back of that too, that's just going to make that even more pronounced. So she thinks a little bit better, but this is about as good of an engage as they're going to get, and she's deciding to commit. So she's looking to go in, can't quite find it. Rammus is surviving all of this because he's goddamn Rammus. We've pretty much repositioned properly at this point, right? We've got our backline. Lucian's a little bit just more of a skirmisher because he can dash in and out. He's pretty mobile. Orianna has to be way in the back, just looking for a key shockwave. So this is a pretty good position. And Shen behind their backline onto their squishy. The fact that their bot lane is in this area, Yasuo isn't quite there yet. He's a little bit off screen, right? But this kind of breaks up where the actual positioning angle is. It's more of a position like this to like this. And we're positioned optimally if it were positioned like this to this. But nonetheless, they're not all here yet. Oops, leave that. They're not all here yet. So we are positioned optimally just by having decent positioning and being there now. So that's good. Shen's doing his thing. Shen actually, we kind of do a split decision at this point because we've got the Baron. So why fight? Why even risk it? Four of us all decide to disengage. Another one of those split calls, unfortunately. Shen keeps trying to focus on the Katarina, chunk her out, make sure she couldn't do anything in a fight that now we're disengaging from. But he realizes, so he's like, shoot, well, let me get the taunt so she can't follow me so readily. Proc a shield for myself in case they do flash to follow me. And run and look for a teleport opportunity. Because his teleport is up right now, right? Beautiful play by Shen. Beautiful play by Shen. Oh my god, I wish I was as good as that Shen. Right? That game sense to know to do that. So wonderful. So, seeing that he's actually going to make this work, that should change our strategy right now. Because this is one hell of a rotation. Because that's a cross in the entire map. That's a full cross map rotation he's doing in an instant because he's getting off a money teleport. So once we see that, the four of us shouldn't continue our plan to disengage. The four of us should be immediately pressuring mid. Right? Ideally, we should chase them down, deny recalls, demand their focus, demand a skirmish that's on our terms. But we need to at least be pressuring that mid wave immediately. Because we have Baron, we need to use it. And he's using it very effectively. And we need to support him. Luckily, they kind of rotate to mid on their own. Orianna winds up being the only one that rotates properly here. Because of that, we lose this turret for free. We lose this turret for free when we should have just been breaking an inhibitor down and making them freak out. Like, if they chose not to come take this for free, I mean, it is free, but if they instead came down here and defend this, we don't get this for free, right? I guess it's a trade. It winds up being a trade of an outer turret for an inhibitor turret, which is not a trade they should be making. You know, so okay, they made a mistake, so we come out okay in the wash. This shouldn't have happened. This is lucky for us, right? And he actually does manage to recall out of there like a boss. Do you see that, Shen? Insane, insane. Best Shen in A. I'm calling it out. Give Cravata a shout out. Tweet at him. I don't know if he has a Twitter. Let him know he's the best Shen NA, though. I've decided it. It has been declared thusly. So whatever. At the end of the day, fine. I could have rotated much better there, right? Would have defended this turret. It would have maybe been able to create more pressure to make this an inhibitor. But whatever. There's an inhibitor available now. All we have to do, we all have Baron. All five of us. All group bottom. And just escort a single minion wave in. Let the minions do the work. Let the minions do the work. Top lane's already going to be pushing out. Mid lane, just by virtue of us sort of running by here, gets the first round of shots off with the Baron empowered cannons and soaks the first round of attacks from the melees with the Baron empowered melee minions. Mid lane's going to be pushing. So look at this, man. Look at this mini map. Mid lane, going to be pushing. Top lane, not quite out yet, but it's going to be pushing, right? It's going to continue to be pushing. Open inhibitor bottom already the most push. We need to rotate, and it's fine from where we're at now. We don't even need to go through this area, right? Because they're here. Sure, we have true sight of where they are, but there's no reason. Drake's coming up, whatever. It doesn't matter. If we create pressure, if we accentuate this pressure in the bottom lane, even if we can't get this inhibitor, at any point we decide it's too late, Baron runs out, somebody gets picked, they're all low, we're all low, we don't want to risk it anymore. All we have to do is rotate back down, pick this up for free. It's another free dragon for us. Be our, just stacking them one after another, it'd be wonderful. But to do that, we have to rotate right now. If we rotate right here through the Silk Road behind the pit, we can meet up with the minions right down here, give them all the Baron buff, and just escort them right into their base. You know, we don't have to cut through here to try and meet up these guys through where we know they're already at. Just gotta rotate. Instead, we see the Baron or the Dragon Timer start getting a little greedy. Speaking for me, start getting a little greedy. Lee Sin's doing something else. He's trying to create a little bit more pressure in the mid lane to make this a more decisive push this way, which we can already start to see from the health totals. It's still going to go in our favor. But hey, no problem in accentuating that. He doesn't have the Baron buff, it doesn't look like. But nonetheless, he is going to push this out just as hard, so it's fine. I'm pretty sure he has... Yeah, he does. That's just a visual bug. The replays are still a little bugged. So I'm trying to set up for Dragon. This is exactly the wrong thing to do when you have Baron. You set up for Dragon by exerting control with Baron, by pressuring all the lanes, and then you can retreat back to Dragon for free. It doesn't matter how much they see you if they're not there. So this is the wrong way to be setting up for this Dragon right now. Rotate back over to mid. This is much better, right? At this point, this rotation is good. Let me support Lee Sin, let me create pressure mid, so then we could fall back to Dragon, then group bot, hit this inhibitor, right? This sweep, forward, back, hit the objective, regroup at minions, pressure next objective, that's fine. And that might even be advantageous too, because then we get another Dragon under our belt before we start this final contest. Yeah, it's not the worst. So this is a good rotation here. We establish and exert control. I stay within the range of the wave, not to try and do anything to Yasuo. Just as far back as I can be from the furthest most minion, I want to make this as long as I can, so I'm not in any danger of Yasuo, but I do give the entire creep wave the Baron buff. Alright? Good positioning there. Step a little bit too far forward here. Sidestep the knockup, so that's good. But nonetheless, I don't need to be this far forward. Again, I'm getting a little greedy seeing that Lee Sin's here and not seeing any enemies nearby. I want to start proccing his shield, start forcing him back, try and bully him out. He doesn't have as hard a time shoving the wave back because Baron only gives the extra resistance to magic damage. He's a full physical damage champion. He looks for a chance to go in, doesn't quite find it, but fine. And now we've all grouped, right? All five of us are here together in mid lane. Again, this is not the lane to be pressuring, right? It's even less the lane to be pressuring, or it's not the worst lane to be pressuring, because we don't want to have to eat through two turrets before we get to an inhib, but this is the lane to be pressuring, you know? So, whatever. Now that we're here, this is fine. We can keep pressuring this, escort minions in, create a siege here. Remember, this is already pushing out. So while we're creating the siege here, right, while we're establishing that this is the line that we're going to fight over, this line is going to be pushing forward the whole time. And right when the minions are about here, then we can rotate top, get this for free, and have a huge wave that's pushing and establishes a new line right outside of their top inhibitor turret. Now again, all of this is poor rotation because there's an open inhibitor in the bot lane. But nonetheless, we could be doing that. That's what we start doing. Start zoning them out, escort some minions forward. Now we're actually broke apart at this point, right? We have the next minion wave coming up, so that could bolster this cannon minion and really push to the actual turret proper. And we only needed to send one if we were deciding to send one to prep out this wave further. But whatever, it's a little sloppy, but it's fine. Now that we see that that's happening, we need to play carefully and disengage. Again, I need to be as far back as possible, so even further back than this. It's too far forward. This is proper. This is the maximum range you can get and still gift that Baron. So again, since there's not a lot of magic damage coming out here, it doesn't matter quite as much. But it does establish that this is the line that they cannot cross while we're getting free time with a large Baron wave. So, okay, that's the right thing to do in this situation. As soon as that's done, rotate. We need to rotate. There's not a wave coming in that we can give Baron to hold the enemy team in this location. So we need to rotate faster than them here. Or we need to try and get into the jungle and have enough vision control over this region, over this triangle right here. If we have proper vision, then we can either find ourselves a pick, likely around here or here, and then we can get a kill, which enables them to get this turret for free. Or we can pressure them to not be able to rotate properly. And if we claim this part of the map for ourselves, then they either have to disengage back completely or come around this long way very safely as we zone them back and get free time on the turret with the Baron up minions. Sticking with my ADC is not bad, especially because he would be one they would try and catch. But nonetheless, this is... I'm lagging behind on what I just described. And because of that, we don't really get an opportune chance. And I just barely miss the hook on her. If I was able to rotate a little bit faster there, maybe that was a hook. Now, we still do get to pincer and zone these guys away. Zone them back. They're aggressively trying to force their way up. It's too late, though. You know, we should have already had this. It would have secured Orianna's passage over. This turret would already be down. These kills would already have happened. Whatever. Now that we're here, this is unfortunate that Ori's not with us. And that's what's going to change the team fight, right? We don't have awareness. I don't think any of us realized that Orianna wasn't with us. So that lack of map awareness is what's going to cost us here. I end up being the first one to go down. I think I go down to run stack. No. I do eventually go down, though. And then Shen is left alone. Fight went really against us. You know? Soon as we got that turret, there was no reason to try and force a fight there. We should have just disengaged. Especially seeing that Ori wasn't there with us. That's on us to disengage. So. They take Baron off of all but two of us. So this is a good rotation by Lee Sin, since they're all topside. Hey, at least I'm going to create pressure mid. Maybe alleviate some of the pressure here. So Lucian can defend this turret a little bit more easily. Unfortunately, Kalista's way deep behind him, so he has to, like, man mode 1v1 this Yasuo, which he actually does a fairly good job of doing. Unfortunately, he misses the Sonic Wave, which would have been the kill. But now Kalista's coming for him. So he's got to find a way out. He's secured it. This is enough to where we know that we have secured a way out. Now look at the vision. This is what we needed beforehand, right? This was a sort of vision we needed beforehand. It's a little late now. And now they're pressuring. Now they've got the minion wave. Here we are now to try and defend it. Turret goes down though. Pop the coin to get them. This is the right spot to be. This is where the action is. Everybody rotated here as proper. But there's no reason it had to rely on the outcome of this fight, right? And again, we aren't with minions, so we're not making use of the Baron here. But we have to take this fight, but that's good on them. Like, they force us to take a fight away from our minions. So, unfortunate. Still do wind up getting the better of this kill, of this fight. I mean, arguably, right? Because they're so low, they have to run. We're all fairly healthy still. We're going back. Lucian goes forward. Does get some free time on this turret. And what turns out to just be another 1-for-1. Because Lee Sin sticks to him pretty well. This turret gets pretty low. So, arguably that was in their favor. I'm not back up yet. Okay. So where's the action right now? Well, what's the objective on the map? The objective is Dragon, Baron, no longer relevant. But both Dragon and, again, remember, this inhibitor is open. We need to get that inhibitor. At least we need to pressure it. So I'm going bottom. Oriana's going to reset mid. Top's already going to push out naturally on its own. Oriana going to reset mid. It might still be pushing in if she doesn't go to the next wave. But nonetheless, she's a big girl. She can manage that on her own. So I'm helping Shen shove this out. I need to, as the one who's the support and as the vision control itemization, need to go more towards dragon, set that up. But I really want to keep pressuring this bottom lane as much as I can. So I don't want to look for any fight. I don't want to look for any aggressive, like, you know, trying to set up zone control. Throw down what wards I can. I was actually anticipating this one to die, which is why I threw this one down on the way out as well. But fine. This wave is now pushing on its own. So looking for an opportunity here is good. But we are not there yet. So I can't go too aggressive, right? We now know that they're on it, though. So we gotta do something. We gotta make the play. And again, because our attention has been drawn away from this, it's inherently in their favor. So it's just a Cloud Drake. So it's not the worst thing if we lose it. But hey, there's a hook on the Calista. Take it in, ball delivery system. Calista gets chunked really hard. We have to kill Calista, right? She is the threat this game. So this is a really good engage for us. Fortunately, Lucian can't quite find a way in through Katarina. And Katarina being much more mobile, gets to dive right in. Or at least start looking for ways to dive right in. While still zoning Lucian. No kills yet. But Orianna's very low, so we're on the negative side of this so far. Killing their smite would be nice to get this dragon. But again, this dragon doesn't nearly matter as much as actually winning the team fight does. Close one, a bloody skirmish. In the end, dragon finally resets. Keep looking for damage on the way out. Can't quite make it work. In the end, both ADCs go down. We also get Katarina. Not bad if we can leave without any more casualties, so I come to bring Shen away, and that's what happens, right? Okay, they get back on the Drake. Whatever, it's a Cloud Drake. It's their first Cloud Drake. It doesn't matter, it's fine. But we need to pressure this. Again, top lane is already pushing in on its own. It's a monster wave, too. And bot lane's already pressuring in on its own. It's a monster wave. So what we could do is go to mid, shove through mid, and then rotate to this wave bottom once it gets about here, and then pressure this. We don't even want to be mid to actually pressure their middle inhibitor turret. We need to go bottom to pressure their open inhibitor. So we need to find that path through mid, right? Yasuo, unfortunately seeing this properly, is resetting the wave right now. Coming up through mid. Pressure. Baron's about to spawn, okay? Changes the dynamic. Now we need to focus on Baron, right? Pressuring mid is good because it allows us to rotate there. I need to start setting up the vision. Get a good sweep of the pit. It's clear. We decide to just start it immediately. Fortunately, can't clear that vision, so they know it. And then they, like, I think that's like four wards. They, like, really know it. Three wards, they really know we're on this. We don't have the best vision, but we have enough vision to know where they are, roughly. So it comes down to this. Katarina is going to TP in inside the pit. This is an opportune turn, but it's a turn onto somebody who is not the best target. So Lee Sin just ends up ulting him away, and it's my job to continue to try and zone and suppress him. We do so. We get the Baron. Perfect. Now we just gotta do evenly even in this fight. I get the Shen ult because I'm about to die. And we're retreating. Very disjointed. We've lost two. Not a good fight for us. We gotta get out of there. Trying to save Rammus. We're trying to save Lucian by flaying Rammus. Lucian actually wanted to get caught in an ultimate. That sets up the easiest hook of my life, so we can actually kill Yasuo, and then look to kill Rammus. I missed the flash hook there, that's really unfortunate. If I had landed that, maybe that changes the entire rest of the game. Those hooks matter a lot. Too far forward, caught out, was thirsting for that, trying to overcompensate for missing that flash hook. Whatever. Should have rotated bomb in here. Again, three of us have Baron. We need to use him. All these waves need to be reset now. Because none of them are pushing in our direction. We do have Baron, so we can use it. Lucian gets caught out. It happens. We were resetting waves. During that time, what was I doing, right? Trying to use the Baron to reset the wave. It's not bad. That's fine. Once I do, that's enough. I don't need to be here any further. But Lucian's already long dead by then, so. Too little, too late. Because of that, they get this turret. Sure, we bring Baron there so they can't get the inhibitor. But now, like, this whole lane has been equalized and we're vulnerable on the top side too. Try to go in to get a kill on Callisto. We find it, thank goodness. Can't quite get that. But there's a Yasuo taking our base. We gotta go back. All our inhibitor turrets are now down from what was, should have been a textbook way to end the game, right? Because of those rotational problems. So, you know, continue to push up. Continue to try and establish the kind of lane equilibrium we want. Escorting the minions as far forward as I can. Not really afraid of Janna, but I overextend. Have to pop coins. I think I wind up having to, having to get ulted by Shen. We then start fighting. Just because it seems like free damage. This is way too hard of a commit onto a GA'd Rammus. And because we blew everything on the GA'd Rammus, this fight goes pretty poorly. We're blasting through this, we could really analyze this, but then we're already over time for the night, or for this episode, so we're just blasting through this fight. What's important is how it worked out. Trust me that blowing all of our load on the GA'd Rammus was not the right choice. It didn't even get his GA down. All of that work for nothing. So, then they get us. That's GG. Yeah. And it really does come down to those rotations. We could have rotated more. I alone could have rotated better, right? I alone could have prepped this wave. It's easy for me to, Monday morning quarterback, say what should have done. Should have been done in a replay. But I know this stuff, man. I know this stuff. You know this stuff. Come to me. Come to me. Let me bring that up. Just so we have it as a reference point in the video for the second part if you'd like to pause it. But now come to me. Come to me. This is an important part. I know this stuff, man. I know this stuff. If there was an open inhibitor and we have Baron, just go to that lane. Just go to that lane. Doesn't have to be the wave that's already pushed up or anything. Just go to whatever wave is safe and start escorting them. You know? Not that hard. It's not that hard. All you gotta do is walk it in. Walk it right in. And we weren't doing that. So, you know. This is a very inappropriate background, but sorry. It's just the wallpaper makes me giggle every time I see it. And these just cycle through my wallpapers. Stay focused on the point I'm talking about, alright? The point is, as we're rotating up, we would be getting that kill. Or we would be getting that inhibitor, rather. For free, because we have Baron. We have Baron on multiple people. We can pick our fight. We can retreat back to the next wave and just hang. We could retreat back and take the free dragon that was up and then have all four dragons. It'd be nice. It'd be nice. It would be a net benefit no matter how it played out. We just never made the play. We didn't make that rotation. And because of that, we wound up losing the game. And there were other rotations sooner in the game that we could have made and had just as much success out of and had just as much an impact on the game. We didn't make those as well. And there was one point in the game pains my soul to even think about this. Remember where I drew in part one, when I walked back and forth between blue buff and underneath the bush I always wore with the control ward at the start of the game? I walked back and forth like 3 times there before going to where the action was happening. It's just like analysis paralysis almost, but with rotations. You know, there's no reason. I need to just go. I need to know what's right and just do it, you know? And if my team is hard committing to something else, I need to recognize that. That changes the situation. And whatever was the correct thing to do, if there's a hard commit elsewhere, that becomes the correct thing to do. And the rotation needs to be made to where the point of action is. If we have hard committed to a point of action elsewhere, I need to rotate over there as quickly as I can. If there's a open inhibitor, and there's no point of action, I need to rotate over to attack the open inhibitor. Especially if I have Baron, I can just carry that with me to some minions. You know? It's just that simple. It feels like a textbook way to close out the game. And I just made the error of not pulling the trigger on it. So, you know, again, there was a number of ways that we could have made a difference that game. Just couldn't make it happen. So, but you know, it's good. It's a fundamental of map rotation, you know, and map awareness and objective awareness. A lot of times I was also focusing too much on just the awareness of Baron and Dragon. I wasn't thinking enough about taking turrets. You know, it's great that I'm so focused on controlling Baron and Dragon. And as when I'm playing support, I establish control around those objectives. So it's good that I be more focused around the jungle objectives. Because we don't just have ambient vision from minions or turrets. But I need to also rotate over turrets as well and establish control around turrets so we can take those safely. Which we weren't able to do because I wasn't rotating properly to the turrets. So, you know, that was the focus for today. Hopefully you guys learned something from that. I know I did. I'm going to take something out of that for sure. If you guys know somebody who you think would benefit from learning a little bit better about rotations, examining some of the rotations, I made some of the mistakes. If you yourself made those mistakes, you know, send them the video. Hit a like if it helped you. Leave a comment if you got any suggestions. We're breaking this up into 2 parts today because this was a bit of a longer one. A lot to break down. This is a bigger concept and it had kind of a different flow to the episode, so we blasted through a lot of the team fights. If you liked blasting through a lot of that and not micro-analyzing positioning as much, let me know. Maybe we'll do more stuff like that in the future. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.